रोल नंबर 12 12 सर जस्ट अनम्यूट हर सो व्हाट वी विल डू दैट यू जस्ट रीड दिस whatever the slide is there because what I did I put entire case studies on the PPT and then we will discuss it out so can you read this paragraph
yes sir NAVIC India's own regional navigation satellite system or IRNSS which is going to debut commercially in the Indian market with Realme X50 Pro which is also the first 5G phone in India. Indian Regional Navigation Satellite System, IRNSS, with an operational name, NAVIC, Navigation with Indian Constellation, is India's own navigation satellite system, which is developed by the Indian Space Research Organization, ISRO.
Okay. So can you comment on this, that what you understood or what you are aware about this? What do you read?
Sir, it is a satellite system which is... It is a satellite system which is developed by, that is made by ISRO.
Yes, correct.
And it will debut in Indian market with... Realme X50 Pro.
Okay.
So it is the first 5G phone in India.
So it is not related to the 5G phone. It is related to the navigation system. Now, yeah. In your phone, which navigation system you are using right now? Are you using any navigation system?
I'm not aware.
You are not aware. Yes, you are aware, but you may not get it. Click. I'll give you one clue. Suppose you want to go to some location. Where do you stay?
Goregaon.
Okay. So from Goregaon, suppose you want to come to the college first time and in the first year and you are not aware where is the college. So what you will do?
Sir, I will use GPS. Yeah.
So this is right. The Indian GPS. This is what GPS we will discuss. We will have the comparison. So this is the Indian GPS. So NAVIC is what it is for the navigation. So navigation means what the GPS is doing. Now, if I'll say the GPS, then you people are aware what your phone will do and what GPS will help you with the reference of the Google map. And then you are coming to the location where you are designed. So this is what the NAVIC. Now, before going into the detail, I'll just give you the clue that why I have selected, why this case study is there. Now, before going, this case study, it will give you, suppose, now you know the GPS, the simple example. Vaishnavi know the GPS, everyone know the GPS. But when you will ask about the NAVIC, you don't know about the NAVIC. Most of you, maybe some of you may be aware about it. Now, this is what the new topic. Now, this is not the complete research. Already the research is done. Only we should be aware about this. Now, if you will study, maybe some papers, some articles, if you will go on Google, you will get so many articles, you will get so many videos and so many things on this. And if you will go through it, then you can prepare one page, two page report. So that will be your understanding about that particular topic. Now, this is what the NAVIC. So similarly, understanding, this is what you can say the first stage of your research, that you should know these things. And if you want to do any project related to this or navigation or GPS related thing, then you can have ideas. Okay. Now we will go for the next. So the next roll number 8, Rishi. Sir will unmute you.
NAVIC is designed.
Yes, Nikhil sir, you just unmute him.
NAVIC is designed to provide accurate position information service to users in India as well as the region extending up to 1,500 kilometer from its boundary. It is powered by 7 satellites, in which 3 of the satellites are located in geostationary orbit and the remaining 4 of them are located in inclined geosynchronous orbit, GSO.
Okay. So what you understand in this?
Sir, NAVIC basically provides the, like from the first statement, it tells that NAVIC basically provides the service for an area from Indian users and also extending from 1,005 kilometers from its boundary. Means the region away from India, nearly 1,500 kilometers, it also provides the position for those areas. And then, sir,
number of satellites, how many number?
Yes,
of
sir, number there are 7 satellites, out of which 3 satellites are located in the geostationary orbit and the other 4 of them are inclined towards the geosynchronous orbit, sir.
Okay, so here the technical details are given. Now what is, yes, the technical, sir, detail? That it is made for what? So one thing is, if I want to give the background, in Kargil war, that US denied to give the location of the Pakistani army and so the other movement. So from that, it has been decided by the Indian government that ISRO should develop this navigation system for our own application. So the focus obviously will be the India, and from the 1500 kilometer boundaries from the India, we can have the navigation. This is the one thing. Then second thing, how it is done? As you know, the GPS system is done by the satellite only. So how many satellites are required? So here only 7 satellites are required. And the 2 orbits are given. The distribution of the orbits are also given. Now, what I will suggest that you just study the orbit location, what are these different orbit and how it is located in the different orbit. Okay, so is this clear? Okay, so now we will go for the next. Nikhil sir, can you do randomly, you can select the any student, you just tell the roll number and then he will read and he will comment on that, or she will comment.
Okay sir. Roll number 63, Urshit.
Yes, sir. It will provide 2 types of service, standard positioning service, SPS, and restricted service, RS. The standard position service, SPS, is available for all the users in India, while restricted service, RS, is restricted to the authorized users only.
Okay. So as I told that, the what is the intention of developing the NAVIC? So here the 2 type of services are developed. So one is for the restricted user, maybe for the military or the other officials, and other is for the general public. So accordingly, the whatever the location is there, whatever the application is there, so that can be utilized. Next. Nikhil sir, next student.
Okay. Roll number 62. Amit.
Territorial. Okay.
Yes, Amit. You just read this first and then you can comment.
Territorial, aerial, and marine navigation disaster
management. Can you speak a little bit loudly?
Territorial, aerial, and marine navigation, disaster management, vehicle training, and fleet management, integration with mobile phone, precise timing, mapping, and geodetic data capture, territorial navigation apps for hikers and travelers, visual and voice navigation for drivers.
Okay. So can you comment on some of the application? What are those?
Like it provides more accurate information than GPS, so it becomes easy for people to track themselves and see some location properly.
Okay. The other disaster management, how it will help?
So like if the marriage is present, then we can see where this something is happening, and we can get the accurate information about that so that our disaster management can be done properly.
Okay. So all these applications are related to the navigation purpose. Okay. So in the disaster management, if you want to move the people from one place to another place, maybe in case of the flood or the other, then the virtual and the voice navigation for the drivers. So mainly for the drivers, you can do the voice navigation. So this, you can say most of these features are already available in GPS, and the reason is that we should have our own. So that's why we are doing this. So these are some applications. Now from this application, what you can do, you can study in detail one or the two application. That is, what are these application and why we require this application. And you can study this and how it work. So this is what the clue that you will get regarding your projects or your studies. And if you will do the updated studies, updated projects, which can be utilized by the society or the industry, so it will be the value addition for you people that you are doing something great. Okay, so next. Nikhil sir.
Rule number 46, Rajan Yadav.
Yes, sir. Though GPS is provided by 30 plus navigation satellites orbiting the Earth, Navic is still better than GPS in terms of accuracy. Navic, through powered by 7 satellites, can provide an absolute position accuracy of better than 10 meters throughout the Indian landmass and better than 20 meters in Indian Ocean, as well as region extending up to 1500 km from its boundary around India. On the other hand, GPS can provide a position accuracy of 20 to 30 meters. The Space Application Center in 2017 confirmed that Navic will provide standard positioning service to all users with a position accuracy up to 5 meters.
Okay. So can you comment on this? What do you understand from this? It is related to the
yes, sir. Sir, this explains that Navic is more accurate than GPS.
Yes.
Which provides accuracy up to 5 meters.
Okay. So the thing is, and GPS is giving accuracy of around
20 to 30 meters. GPS.
Yes. So you can just compare that how much accurate this is. Can you comment on this? Accuracy means what in terms of your application, what you are using?
Sir, maybe where the person is located around 5 meters off, there it will be showing in map.
May not be this way directly. I'll explain. So what happened? 20 to 30 meter means if you are using a Google map and you are going somewhere, and the accuracy, suppose it's saying that you take a left turn, you take a right turn, So the accuracy of that in GPS, it is around 20 to 30 meter. Means the error may be up to plus minus 20 to 30 meter in that where your exact location is there and what the Google map is showing. Okay, this is what.
Okay.
But this will be more accurate in the Navik, that is up to 5 meter. Okay. So how many times if you consider the 20 meter, so it is better than the 4 times. Okay, 4 to 6 times, it is better than the existing system. And we will not be depend on anybody else. It is our own Indian system. So this is not the case that we appreciate that the foreign countries are able to develop the excellent technology. It is not the case. We are also able to develop the excellent technology, and this is what one of the example of the whatever the accuracy is there, because accuracy is the most important thing. And this is recently developed. Okay, maybe in next 1 or 2 years we all will get it in hand in your mobile phone, probably when we'll go for the 5G. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Then next, sir. Nikhil, sir, next student.
Rule number 28, Neil. Rule number.
Neil, are you muted? Sir, he is not muted. Please unmute. Nikhil, sir.
Rule number 7, Akhilesh.
Yes, sir.
Akhilesh, can you turn on your camera? Is it possible?
Sir, 1 second. Yes, sir.
Now go ahead.
Navic has a dual frequency, that is S and L bands, whereas GPS is dependent on L band only. When a low frequency signal travels through the atmosphere, its velocity changes due to atmospheric disturbances. United States Bank, on the atmospheric model, to assess frequency error, and it has to update this model from time to time to assess the exact error.
Okay, so what you understand from this? Okay, I'll just explain and then you can comment, because this is somewhat technical and new topic. There are multiple bands given by the IEEE. For your purpose, the NAVIC is working in two band, S band and L band. So there are some gigahertz frequencies. Okay, and here in the NAVIC, two frequencies are given, that is S band and L band. But in GPS, only one frequency is given, that is L band. So if there is the atmospheric change, now there is a rainy season, and you will have the other season. So this atmospheric change, what it do, it provide an impact on the functioning of this. The best example is what? If you will have a TV dish dish receptor, so in the if there is a heavy rain, then you are not able to see the whatever the TV program properly. Is it correct, Akhilesh?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So similarly, means what is happening? It is affecting the performance. There are various reasons. So you can go in detail about the various reasons. I just give you the whatever the what are the various bands that you can study. That is the IEEE bands that are in gigahertz. That were mainly used for the satellite communication. This is what we are using for satellite communication. So what is the S band range? What is the L band range? That you can find it out. Simple, if you will do the Google, you will get it. And in the L band, what is the GPS frequency? What is the NAVIC frequency? That also you will get. So I'll give it, kept it to you to study. So these are the various band. So what it is saying here, that by using the two band, it is robust to the atmosphere. And as compared to the GPS, it is robust and the functioning will be more better. Okay. So we will go for next. Nikhil sir, the next student.
Rule number 14, Avinav Singh. Rule number 14, Avinav Singh.
Yes, sir. Case study, NAVIC. In October 2019, Qualcomm announced that they will be adding support for NAVIC to their upcoming chipsets. In January 2020, Qualcomm announced the launch of three new chipsets, Snapdragon 720G, 622 and 460, which will support NAVIC. But with the launch of Realme X50 Pro, powered by Snapdragon 865 chipset featuring NAVIC, shows that Snapdragon 720G, 622 and 460 are not the only chipsets to support it.
Okay.
So here it basically says about the technical chipset part of which is involved in NAVIC, and it says that it is not restricted to only the three chipsets, which is 720G, 622 and 460. It also supports various different chipsets like Snapdragon 865 as well.
Okay. Now, this is what the chip number and all these things. But if you will develop any system, so for developing system, you need a hardware. You need a system which will receive it. Now, things that we require in your mobile phone, we require that special because it is operating on the different frequency, as we discussed in the previous slide. That is, two different bands are there. So GPS chip will not be applicable here. We have to have another hardware. So the development of this hardware is done and it has been tested. So the different chips has been given. I can say proudly that for the development of the antenna of the NAVIC, me and my one student, postgraduate student, we were the part. And last year, we have developed one antenna for the NAVIC. In association, we had the for the ME project, the student was associated with the Samir, that is the at IIT Bombay, this institute is there. And there, she has develop the antenna. So we had the collaboration. So we also can contribute in such projects. So the intention of putting this data is ISRO launch so many projects. You can go to the website of the ISRO. Now it is open to almost all the students and faculty. And you just search for the project. If you are passionate about doing some great thing in your life, so you can just search. You can talk to me or your any faculty, the related domain faculty, and you can start with this project. So if you will start such projects in your third year itself, so you have next four semester, and after the four semester, you will have something concrete. The service or the product will be in your hand. This is what one of the, what you can say, outcome of this activity, what we are doing. So it is not simply the information gathering. We are not doing it only for the information gathering. It is what from this information, we have to motivate ourselves to go ahead for the next thing, the what we can do. Okay. Now we will go for the next. Yes, sir.
Rule number 11, Natasha.
Yes, sir.
Yes, Natasha.
Case study Navik. Like Realme, Xiaomi is also preparing to launch its upcoming mobile, which will feature the nation's navigation satellite system. Manu Kumar Jain, Global VP of Xiaomi and MD of Xiaomi India, announced that the upcoming Redmi phone will feature India's own regional navigation satellite system, Navik. Henceforth, all the upcoming phones which will be provided by these Snapdragon chipsets will have support for Navik.
Okay. So what do you understand?
One second, sir.
Now, previously, we discussed the development of the chips. Now, this chip should be included in your phone. So we should have the phones which will have the chip, and so that the people like you and me and all Indians can use this Navik system. So this development has been done by the company name, and the details are given. Okay.
Yes.
So the now in it is a matter of time that maybe in next few months or the year we will have a phone which will have the Navik as the navigation system. Understood?
Yes, sir. Okay. Yes, sir.
Okay. Now we'll go ahead, sir. Next.
Rule number 20, Kinjal Singh.
Yes. Case study Navik. It will be exciting to see how India's navigation satellite system will work and if it can really beat the GPS as told. Russia has Global Navigation Satellite System, GLONASS. Europe has Galileo, China has Lido, which are operational globally. Japan has QZSS, which is the regional navigation satellite system. GPS lacks in navigating through densely built areas, but soon it will be covered by Navik, which has better accuracy than GPS.
Okay, what you understood?
It is trying to tell that soon the Indian navigation satellite system will beat the GPS, other GPS systems, and there are some problems when this system navigates through densely built areas, but these issues will be covered by Navik, which has better accuracy system than other GPS, which are mentioned above.
Yes. So there are 5-6 countries are mentioned here. They are having their own navigation system, and India is one of them. So around 200 countries are there in the entire globe, and 5-6 are there. They are having their own navigation system. So India is one of them. Okay. So we will go for the next. This is the last. Now, based on this, these are some sample questions. And intentionally, I kept all these questions are very simple. But it is not simply the question answer. You people, these questions you can answer very simply if you will read once or twice. But the intention of this is